Hi everyone. Today I have an interesting story. There was a buffalo kid, you know, a buffalo child, who was very curious and he was a very bright child. And as he was growing up, one day he asked his father, "Father, I'm so huge, you know, I have a big body, I've got these sharp horns and I've got sharp teeth even, and I can run pretty all right. So do I need to be scared of anything in this world?" Now the father thought about it and he said that, "Oh son, not really, but then you need to be scared of the lions." Now why? Because lions have the ability to pounce on you and kill you, and they like to eat buffalo meat. So you need to be a little careful about the lions. Now the buffalo kid said, "Oh, next time when I see a lion, I'm going to run away, because I can't fight it and he can pounce on me." Now the father said, "No son, that's not really a good idea, because if you run away, the lion is going to chase you and pounce on you and surely kill you. So you don't have to run away." Now buffalo kid says, "If I don't have to run away, what do I need to do? I mean, how will I face the lion?" So the father said, "You know what, you need to stand your ground, look at the lion in the eyes and just, you know, wait for lion to get scared and run away." And the kid says, "Now, if suppose that doesn't happen, the lion doesn't run away, then what do I do?" Then the father said, "Then you have to flex your muscles, you know, show off your horns and the teeth and your huge body so that the lion gets really scared." Now, the kid said, "No, but then since lion loves to eat buffalo, he may not get scared at all and he may not still run away." Now, the father says, "Oh, that's a good question. Now let me ask you something. Why don't you look behind and see what is there?" Now the buffalo kid looks behind and there is this herd of buffalo, which is his family, like about 100, 200 buffaloes, and all huge with these big horns and, you know, very, very powerful. And the kid says, "Oh, these are my uncles and aunts and cousins, and they are all family. And they are people with whom we move around all the time." So the father said, "If you keep looking at the lion and if you keep trying to scare the lion away and he doesn't go away, then we are all behind you and we are going to support you. And can you imagine if 200 buffaloes go running at the lion, what will happen?" So the buffalo kid said, "Yes, yes, yes, then the lion will run away for sure." So the father said, "Do you understand what I'm saying? Anybody who is in your life and who is willing to help you can also only help you when you face your fear, when you face your lion. If you run away, then the lion will come after you and he will surely kill few of us and go back, and we will not really be able to help you. So if you want us to help you, first you have to face the fear with all the might you have." And I think that goes the same for human beings. We all have lions in our lives. So when we are faced with our lion, what do we do? Do we run away or do we face the lion with all our might and we bare our teeth and we show off our horns and we take on the lion? Because when we do that, people who do want to help us, people who can help us, they can help. Otherwise, if we run away from the fear, nobody can help us. So the first thing is that we all have fears, we all have lions. We have to accept that. And after accepting, we have to know that we have to conquer that fear. And for that, we will need help of other people. But the help will come when we have helped ourselves, when we have faced that fear. So if you really want to be happy, face your fears. Don't run away from them. Because when you run away, you are sure to die. It may not just be physical death. You will die mentally and emotionally. Not worth it. So face your fear, find your lion, and chase the lion. Yeah. Bye. This is all for today. This is Coach Anupma saying bye-bye.